Today I'd like to demonstrate to you how I would paint red hair. Hi, I'm Sara, and I make art. Just like I showed you that when painting blonde hair, we mix purple with our yellow. Well, when painting red hair, we mix green with our red. It's because these are complementary colors, and the addition of the green will make the red more brownish, and therefore more natural looking. But the model that I'm using also has a bit of a golden tone to her hair, and I was wondering to myself, how do I make that? The obvious choice was to add yellow, but if you add yellow to red, of course you just get orange. And I really didn't want orange. If you've ever looked at someone with naturally red hair, you probably know that it doesn't look like the red that comes out of your crayon box. I played around for a bit, and I came up with a combination of the red and green, which I was going to use anyway, yellow ochre, which was my first thought as a replacement for yellow, and actually even a bit of yellow on top of that. And I thought this combination looked pretty good. But I decided to add some purple to it, and that's that light kind of golden color that you've seen me lay down. So far, I've been laying down all my colors using a wet into wet technique, and while I thought the result was pretty, I really didn't think it looked like hair. But don't worry, I did manage to resolve this, and I'll talk more about that when I get to that part in the video. In the meantime, for the darker tones, I didn't think it was looking quite red enough. You saw me add red on top earlier, and I did that while the paint was still wet so that the colors would blend together. I just had a little bit of the color on the edge of my brush. That and the fact that the water on the paper helped to dilute the paint is what made it subtle enough for me. But I want to add here that even though I wanted the red to be subtle, I actually want you to be able to see redness in the hair. I mean, this is a tutorial on painting red hair after all. So even though I don't want in-your-face red, I still want there to be a red tone in there. So ultimately, it's all about balance. And I have some parts of the top that are going to be so bright, they're actually going to look white. And don't worry about that green there. Most of it came off when I took the masking fluid off. And speaking of, if you're wondering about masking fluid, I made a whole video about it. I'll link it in the description below. And also in the description, I'll have affiliate links for the products that I'm using. If you buy from those links, I guess small percentage at no extra cost to you. This part down here that you're seeing, I thought I'd paint it like maybe a reddish purpley color, and I fought with it a lot, and at the end of the day I decided to just blot it all out with the tissue and let that just be a darker version of the same golden color that I've been using throughout the hair. You see here I thought it was too red, so I tried layering green over it, but then it was too green, so that part just didn't work out. My darker color is a combination of burnt sienna and yellow with the red mixed in on top. Now I'm ready to tell you how I got this painting from what is this mess to something that I think actually works. It's very easy for me when the painting gets to the stage to think that I've ruined the piece after I've just started. But things started to change. It started to turn around for me when I started adding my smaller pieces, these smaller strands that you're seeing now, over the dry paint. You can see that as I lay these dark strands down and I follow the shape they are and I extend them down toward the end, the lighter colors already there also starts to take shape. And the hair takes on this PC look that I wanted it to have from the beginning. And there's almost like these extra layers are making the negative space, even though it's not really negative space because there's actually color on the paper. But it's kind of like these extra strands are making that other color work for me. I want to show you my painting Couple in Costume at Balboa Park Centennial. This was actually the first time that I had to paint someone with red hair, and I knew I couldn't just use red out of the tomb, so I went out on a limb and decided to mix green into the red, and what do you know? It worked. As with blonde hair or brown hair, red hair comes in an array of shades, but one thing I want you to remember with pretty much all shades of red hair is don't use a red. I mean, don't just take your red tube of paint like this and just paint it all over and say, oh, that's the hair done. Unless you're either painting a cartoon or you're painting someone with a weird dye job. Fire engine red hair is not natural. Thank you so much for watching. I make art videos every week with tips and demonstrations like this one. So if that sounds good to you, click here to subscribe. They're absolutely free. And I'll see you again next time. Bye!